सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणुधातुगुरो वेदाग्निशिरोशरणुं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So, the next sutra, 28th sutra, in the first pada of the second chapter is introduced by saying, Jagataha Brahma Vivartatvena. The prapancha is Vivarta of Brahma that was established. As to, it is not Parinama, it is Vivarta of ब्रह्मा विच इज अभिन्न निमित्तोपादान कारण। सो जगत ब्रह्म विवर्तत्वेन सिंस प्रपंच इज कल्पित इन ब्रह्मा एंड देर इज नो रियल चेंज इन ब्रह्मा स्वप्न प्रपंचवत मायिकत्वात्। वाई सो इट इज सिमिलर टू द स्वप्न प्रपंच विच इज विवर्ता ऑफ द स्वप्न द्रष्टा। दि स्वप्नद्रष्टा जीव इज द कारण फॉर द स्वप्न प्रपंच वेर ही बिकम्स द सीयर द वर्ल्ड विच इज सीन विथ दि सेंशियंट एंड इनसेंशियंट बीइंग्स और थिंग्स एंड ऑल्सो द क्रिया। सो द एंटायर त्रिपुटी All the karakas in the swapna are nothing but the vivarta of jiva because jiva does not change even a little bit. So jagataha brahma vivartatvena swapna prapanchavat mayikatvat. The prapancha is mayika, maya karya or maya sambandini, some maya sambandhi प्रपंच जगत और इट इज जस्ट मैजिकल ऑल्सो। यू कैन से मायिका मीन्स हाउ इट अपियर्स, इट्स मैजिकल, देर इज नो एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवन। एल्सवेयर इन मानसोल्लास भगवान सुरेश्वराचार्य, मानसोल्लास इज अ टीका, इज अ व्याख्या ऑन भगवत्पादाचार्य दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्र। It is in the form of shlokas, a lot of shlokas. So there, in one shloka, Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya says that this appearance of the prapancha is a brahma. Meaning, he does not say that, but it is known. It is explained across the shlokas of the Mula Dakshinamurti Sotra as well as the Tikas. But what is this Brahma? What is the Lakshana of Brahma? And later, what is the Lakshana of Maya? So there is a similar explanation for Brahma as well as Maya. The Lakshana, Lakshana meaning definition. He says that there is no definition possible for Brahma or Maya as Sat or Asat. Satyatvena and Asatyatvena, both Lakshana is not possible. That is the artha there, Lakshana not being possible. And then he says, why so? The hetu given is Yuktihinatvat. So there is some appearance, but it is bereft of logic. You cannot logically explain and establish as to how this Brahma has come about. Nobody can really explain. There are explanations given, but there is no entirely convincing descriptive definition possible which is convincing to everyone, all darshanikas, non-darshanikas also, astikas, nastikas, as well as those who don't care for anything, but they know that pratyaksha is a pramana and they use logic without knowing, but they use it. There is no such definition possible which is acceptable to everyone as to how the rope appears as snake. Only Advaita gives somewhat closer to acceptable explanation with avidya, but then how the sarpa utpatti takes place in Rajju, that is anirvachaniya. And anirvachaniya really means that it cannot be categorized as sat as asat. Why? Because we just understand sat and asat. We do not understand anything which is in between. Is it real or is it unreal? When it is neither real nor unreal, then what is it? Na ubhayatmikam. It cannot be sat as well as asat together. Why? Virodhatva. Virodhat. Because there is virodha. You cannot have contradictory sat and asat coming together. So the reasoning given in Manasollasa is that if at all there had been a lakshana, Brahma eva na syat. Brahma itself wouldn't have been possible. The very definition of Brahma being possible, it wouldn't have been categorized as Brahma at all. Because lakshana is not possible, then alone you can say it is Brahma or it is anirvachaniya, avidya, maya, maya karya, avidya karya. All these explanations are there only because it cannot be pointed out as this or that. Idam ittham. Therefore, mayikattvam. That mayikattvam means yukti hira bhrame. In the yuktihina brahma, some explanation has to be given, and there you say unto such vishayas. Yuktihine vishaye mayikattvam. Only mayikattvam can be talked about with respect to such vishayas. So as the magic, you know, when you talk about something magical, even, you know, in today's era, hypnosis accepted by some as some part of science. Scientific explanation is possible, but those who do not know that and you go and look at some show, it appears as magic. And if it's really magic as per, you know, Atharvaveda ityadi, where mantra kruta karya is possible, which cannot be explained, it is all alaukika. Meaning the upaya is alaukika, but the phala, you see, laukika phala is attained. So that is all magical, mayikam. So mayika can also be magical. So therefore, whichever meaning is acceptable, jagataha brahma vivartatvena swapna prapanchavat mayikatvat. How? Example is swapna. In swapna does it appear? Do you overthink it, saying that, oh, how could I have seen so much, lived such a long long time, I lived in this kind of a situation, whether it is a nightmare or, you know, whether it is a very blissful dream, still, do you overthink as to, you know, how could I have been in such a situation for such a long time while sleeping only for 15 minutes, half an hour, whatever it is? We don't overthink it, we just accept it because it is pratyaksha to us, it is anubhava siddha. On waking up. But we do not think that on waking up it is mayika, swapna prapancha. During the swapna also, even if it is anubhava siddha as real, you are living that dream, but still it is mayika. We don't think that. Similarly here, while we are watching this jagrat swapna, इट्स अ वेकिंग ड्रीम. वी डोंट थिंक इट, थिंक एज इट कुड बी ड्रीम दैट आई माइट वेक अप फ्रॉम दिस सिचुएशन ऑल्सो ड्यू टू श्रुति. देर बाय तद उपादानत्वे अपि, जगद उपादानत्वे अपि, ब्रह्म इज उपादान कारण ऑफ प्रपंच. इवन देन ब्रह्मणा न कृष्ण प्रसक्त्यादि दोषः स्वप्न साक्षिण इव इत्याह. सो इट वॉज एक्सप्लेन्ड अर्लियर एज टू दिस कृष्ण प्रसक्ति और शब्दकोप. इधर यू लैंड इन परमात्मा नॉट बीइंग देर बिकॉज ही हैज कन्वर्टेड हिमसेल्फ इन टू दिस प्रपंच बाय परिणाम, और यू हैव टू से दैट नो परमात्मा कैनॉट चेंज बिकॉज देर इज नो निरवयत्वम सावयत्वम एंड देर फोर एन अंश हैज चेंज एंड दे लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ परमात्मा स्टिल रिमेन्स थ्री क्वार्टर्स. देन देर विल बी शब्द कोपा बिकॉज श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट ब्रह्म हैज निरवय नॉट सावय. दैट इज मेन्शन हियर एज टू इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इट एज विवर्त कारण, ब्रह्म हैज विवर्त कारण, देन ब्रह्मण न कृष्ण प्रसक्त्यादि दोष, देर इज नो कृष्ण प्रसक्ति दोष एंड नॉर इज देर शब्द कोप. हाउ? अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज स्वप्न साक्षिण इव इत्याह. सो इवन देन इवन इफ उपादान कारणत्व इज एक्सेप्टेड बाय पूर्वपक्षी ऑल्सो एज पर सिद्धांति, इवन देन देर विल बी नो सच दोष एंड पूर्वपक्षी शुड एक्सेप्ट दैट स्वप्न example which is given by Siddhanti holds good here. Thereby Atmani Chaivam Vichitraschahi, Atmani Chaivam Vichitraschahi. So Atmani in Atma, in which Atma? This Jivatma who is Swapna Drashta. So in the Swapna Drik, Swapna Drishi, Atmani Cha Evam. Evam means this Vichitra Shrishti has come up, Swapna Shrishti has come up in the Atma which is Niravayava and basically one without a second. So Vichitraschahi, Vichitraha Shrishtaya, so Shrishtya. So you see such Shrishti also in Atma during Swapna Avastha. So he is what he asmat heto. Since in Swapna you have such an example possible, Atmani cha evam vichitraha cha, he is the padachheda there, he is yata yasmat karanat. Since you see yasmat heto ho, you see in loka everyone has anubhava, every jiva has an anubhava of Swapna where one, a single oneself has become multiple in the Swapna. Whatever is in the Swapna is all the Swapna Drashta. He yasmad hetoho ekasmin atmani Swapna Drishi. In one single Atma who is a Swapna Drashta, Swapna Drik, in that single Jivatma, Swapna Drashta, Niravayava, who is also Niravayava, there are no parts there, Niravayave, Vichitraha Srishtayaha Shruyante. Vichitra Srishtis are heard. And it is not only Shruyante, Anubhava Siddha also. And if you need Shruti Pramana, then there is Shruti Pramana also. Na tatratha na ratha yogaha. So Shruti says, Brihat Shruti says that there are no rathas in the, there are no chariots in the Swapna, but in Swapna, Prapancha there are chariots. In the Atma there are no rathas, chariots are not there, but chariots are seen. And really are they existent? You cannot say that really they are existent. Can you say they are unreal? You cannot say they are unreal because why? Drishyatvat. Had they not been there, they wouldn't have been seen. And if you say they are, then they are real, except that they are real, you cannot. Why? They wouldn't have gone. So sachin na badhyeta, asachin na pratiyeta. There is a pratiti, therefore, there is a darshana of these pratiti appearance. Therefore, these rathas and the paths, ratha yogaha, all these, the path on which the roads on which the chariots and horses run, the horses, the chariot, everyone there, everything inclusive, is all not real, not unreal also. Asachena badhyeta, asachena badhyeta, asachena pratiyeta. Had they been unreal, then there wouldn't have been an appearance. Then they are not unreal. Are they real? Had they been real, then on waking up, they wouldn't have gone. Therefore, sachet na badhyeta. Ityado, yathacha loke mayavini swarupa swarupa anupamardaneneva. So, upamardana in keeping with swarupa. Swarupa upamardaneneva hastya ashwadi vichitraha srishtyaha. There is a type here, srishtaya, this should have been srishtaya, srishtaya drishyante. So there is a vichitra srishti darshana, hastya ashwadi. In the loka where mayavini, in the magician, there is anupamardana. Anupamardana is, it's a nanj, I said anu. In keeping with the mayi swarupa, if you see something, then you should see mayavi, not mayi, mayavi. Mayavi is the magician in the world. So if you look at magician swarupa, then what is it? It is this magician person. But what do you see? You see hasti, ashwadi, you see elephant, you see horse, etc. He has projected those. And has he been destroyed by that? Upamardana. Has he become hasti ashwadi really, and therefore mayavi himself is not there anymore? Is such a situation there during the magic show? It isn't so. So swarupa anupamardanena. Anupamardena. So there is no destruction of mayavi, there is no real transformation of mayavi, but there is an appearance of this magician mayavi as hastyashwadi ityadi. He is projecting without changing himself, and thereby vichitraha srishtayaha drishyante evam ekasmin api brahmani vivida srishtir ityartha. Similarly, in a single undivided brahma, there is variety of creation, this creation with a variety which is tending to infinity. That is the 27th sutra. The next sutra is introduced by saying yascha ubhayo samaha dosha iti nyayena krishna prasaktyadina anudbhavyatvam darshayati. Just give me a moment, please. Forgot to switch on the fan, and I closed the windows because it's noisy. And the weather, anyway, well known that it is horrible. Okay, so now the Siddhanti says, I have answered your questions. As per the Siddhanta, whatever doshas you have pointed out, they aren't there in Advaita Vedanta, Siddhanta or Paksha. However, you should not have been raising these doubts at all. You, the Purvapakshi, whether you are a Sankhya or a Tarkika, both have used Tarka, but while pointing out doshas of Krishna Prasakti ityadi in Advaita Vedanta, you have ended up by raising the same akshepas on your darshana also. And whatever is a dosha, whatever could be seen as a dosha in one's own darshana, should not be raised against others. You should be able to answer the same question in your darshana, if at all you raise the question towards others darshana. So yascha ubhayo samaha dosha, We are not saying that there is a dosha. Dosha as pointed out by the Purva Pakshi. That there won't be any karana. In our case, Paramatma, there won't be any karana left if there is parinama. And if at all there is no entire parinama, then there would be partition caused in the karana, and therefore this karana would be what? Vibhakta, would be segmented, and there will be Shruti Kopa. So here now what is being shown is that in the case of Sankhyas, the Pradhana being transformed, there won't be any Pradhana left after Srishti is created, or in the case of Tarkikas, the Karana Anu, Paramanus won't be left if they have converted themselves into something else, Karya, or there is no Shruti Kopa here because there is no Shruti basis for both of these Darshanas. So instead of Shruti Kopa, Shabda Kopa, we are saying that your darshana, whatever is your darshana sutras are claiming, they are countered because you are saying that these are indivisible. Pradhana is indivisible because Pradhana is not made up of parts, nor are Parmanu made of parts. Parmanu is defined as that which does not have any parts. Invisible but still cannot have parts. Therefore, Dvyanuka has parts, Tranuka has parts. So, Dvyanuka, Tranuka will be an assembly of these Parmanus. But Parmanus themselves are without any segments, without any parts, Aunshas. Therefore, your darshana itself will be compromised because having said that they are partless, you will have said that because I want Parmanus and Pradhana or Pradhana to survive, you will have to say what? You will have to say that they are still there, a part, Aunsha of Pradhana, Aunsha of Parmanus have converted. If at all you make such a claim, then your darshana will be compromised because they are supposed to be partless. So same doshas will accrue to your own paksha, your own darshana, and therefore you shouldn't have raised these doubts at all. Although we have answered, now those doshas will accrue to your own darshanas, and since I have answered, they will not accrue to my darshana, says the Siddhanti. Yascha ubhayoho samaha dosha. Ubhayo means between the Purva Pakshi and the Siddhanti. Iti Nyayena. That should not have been raised. Iti Nyaya. That is a Nyaya. In a debate, you should not point out something. Basically, what? In the Nyaya, we have this in probable statements in English also, or in Hindi also. So, those who stay in the glass houses should not throw stones at others. So, Iti Nyayena Krishna Prasatyadinam Anubhavyattvam Darshayati. So, there is, in your paksha also it is seen. It is there in your paksha. He shows that how swapaksha doshat cha, swapaksha doshat cha. So, swapaksha doshat cha, and also due to your own paksha doshas, which we have already seen in the introduction to this sutra. Sankhyadaya api niravayam pradhanam jagat parinami iti angi chakruhu. So what have Sankhyadaya angi chakru, what have they accepted? They have accepted that pradhana, which is jagat parinami karana, that jagat parinami upadana karana pradhana is niravayava, it is partless. Adipadena tarkikaha, Nyaya Vaisheshikas, they consider paramanus as Jagat Karana, and Paramanus themselves are Niravayava. Tathacha Krishna Prasatyadi Dosha Samana. Therefore, the doshas which have been pointed out as to by Parinama, after Parinama, Karana, Upadana Karana is no longer existent. So, the dosha is common to the Purva Pakshi also when he raised the question against the Siddhanti. Anuvadina api. Anuvadina are the Tarkikas. So, Anuvadina api. Parmanudvaya Sanyogina Dvyanukadi Srishtim Uriri Chakruhu. So they have also said, the Anuvadis have said what? They have said that the Srishti of the Prapancha, such as Dvyanuka Adi, Dvyanuka, Tranuka, etc., the two atoms come together, then those come together to form Trenuka. So all this, starting from the sanyog of two atoms, that kind of a creation begins with paramanu coming together. So paramanu, but the sanyoga is of the between the paramanu. Paramanu dvaya sanyoga. Dvaduka is a name given to that which is born after sanyoga between two paramanus, two atoms. So now this atom is indivisible as per their darshana, and it is, this is a niravayava. So anuvadinopi paramanu dvaya sanyoga dvadukaadi srishtim kurari chakruhu sa sanyoga kim vyapya vrittihi avyapya vrittirva. This is what I had mentioned in the last part. This sanyoga, is it vyapya vrittihi or avyapya vrittihi? Vyapya vritti means what? If at all there is sanyoga between paramanu and another paramanu, that paramanu's part should be having sanyoga with another paramanu's part. You cannot have entire paramanu merging with another paramanu with sanyoga. You cannot have the whole having sanyoga with the whole. Association of the whole with the whole is not possible. If you have a pot touching the hand, hasta pustaka sanyoga, let's say the hand touching the book, entire book cannot be touched by the hand. Even if it is a small, you know, a pocket book and your hand is big, if you hold the entire book in your palm, still the inner part of the book will not have been touched. Not each and every page entirely will be touched. Only the outside part will have been touched. Even there would be gaps. The boundaries of the book would not have been touched by the hand. The side boundaries of the pages. So there is no possibility of vyapya vrittihi. That is called as vyapya vrittihi. Then avyapya vritti, let us be avyapya vritti. So there dosha is pointed out. Adye vyapya vrittyau sati. If at all you say sanyoga between two paramanus is vyapya vritti, then drishta virodha, you don't see such things. Kutrapi vyapya sanyoga na drishta asmabhi. Yata hasta pustaka sanyoga adu. There is no possibility of vyapya vritti sanyoga. There is no pramana, laukika pramana, no pratyaksha pramana for, there is no anubhava. Such a thing is never seen as to vyapya vritti being possible. Dvitiye savayavattvam. So if you say avyapya vritti, if you say avyapya vritti means what? A part of one paramanu is touching the other, whether whole or part. Anyway, whole, sanyoga of whole with a part or a whole is not possible. So you will have to accept that a part of one paramanu and part of another paramanu is touching each other, there is a sanyoga between them, and thereby dvaduka is born. If at all you accept that, then what will happen? There is a part in paramanu. Dvitiye savayattvam. So savayattva will be dosha. And why? Dvitiye savayattvam vina avyapya vritti sanyoga anupapattihi. There is no possibility of avyapya vritti, meaning a part touching a part, without the two things having sanyoga being with parts. Savayava. So niravayatvam of your darshana will be compromised. Therefore what? Niravayatva vyakopaha. So your darshana which talks about niravayatva of paramanus, that will be compromised. Vyakopaha ityadi dosha samana. So you have said shabda kopaha because our entire darshana is based on shabda, shruti pramana. Yours is based on your own darshana. Therefore your darshana which talks about niravayatva, there will be vyakopa, whether it is tarkika or who have paramanuvada, or whether it is sankhyas who have pradhanavada, pradhana karana or paramanu karana, both will have these doshas. Ityadi dosha samana brahmavadesa dosha na samasti. Although we say samana dosha, we have already answered questions which have been raised by you. Therefore brahmavade asmakam brahmavade asmakam vedantinaha vedantinam brahmavade. In our Vedantis Brahmavada, these doshas, which dosha? Krishna Prasaktyadi dosha. Krishna Prasakti as well as Niravayatva Vyakopa or Shabda Kopa. Na samasti. Nasti. There is no possibility also. Why? We have answered that as to earth is a vivartavada. Tasmat upapannaha brahma karana vadaha. Therefore, the samanvaya in Brahma's karana is still holding good. Thereby, this adhikarana, the Krishna prasakti adhikarana is over. Now, the next adhikarana, saropeta adhikarana. Saropeta adhikarana is introduced by the sutrakara, by the vritti, by saying, Purvokta vichitra karya shaktimatto vishaya shanka nirasena samartha samarthanatmakatvat vishaya vishaya bhava sangatya idamaha. There is a vishaya vishaya sangati between these two, the earlier adhikarana, Krishna prasaktyadi adhikarana, and saropeta adhikarana. So Krishna prasaktyadhikarana is a vishaya and this adhikarana is a vishayi, the next adhikarana. How so? Purvokta vichitra karya shaktimatva vishaya shanka nirasena. The vishaya earlier, in the earlier adhikarana was what? There was purvokta, what was stated earlier, vichitra karya shaktimatva. The vichitra karya shakti, man, paramatma, or in Napunsakalinga Brahma, vichitra karya shakti mat Brahma was established even while being ekameva dvitiyam Brahma. Even then there is vichitra karya shakti in that Brahma, meaning there is shakti to create prapancha which is variegated. In each and every aspect that you analyze, you see variety in the prapancha that has come up from Brahma, which has no variety. There is no second. That Advitiya Brahma is the karana. So that vishaya, how is it possible? How can vichitra srishti be possible from eka niravaya Brahma? Thereby shanka was there, that was the vishaya. And having refuted that vishaya shanka nirasena samarthanatmakatvat, there was an acceptance as to it is possible by vivarta, not by parinama, but by vivarta it is possible. So purva adhikarana is vishaya and this adhikarana is vishayi. So vishaya vishayi bhava sangatya idamaha sarvopeta adhikaranam. So this adhikarana says, first sutra says sarvopeta chatad darshanat. So sarvopeta adhikarana sarvashakti. Sarvashakti mat brahma is being discussed here, therefore it is sarvopeta adhikarana. Sarvopeta chatad darshanat. So this paramatma is sarva shaktiman. Sarvopeta has sarvopeta means sarva yukta, and sarva yukta is what? Sarva is what? There sarva is sarva shakti, or everything that you see in the prapancha is the vibhuti of Brahma, paramatma. Thereby Brahma is sarvopeta. Tad darshanat, darshana is shruti. Since there is a shruti, darshana is shruti and shrutehe heto tad darshanat heto. You see such a thing being there, tasya sarva shakti mataha brahmanaha darshanat. You see that Brahma being discussed in shruti, who is endowed with sarva shakti. Tasmat hetu, due to that reason Brahma is sarva shaktiman. Phalam tu purvat, meaning samanvaya siddhi in purvapaksha and samanvaya siddhi in siddhanta. Asharirasya namaya iti nyayena maya shakti mataha brahmana jagat sargam bruvan samanvaya viruddhyate nava iti sandehe. when there is a doubt as to there is a virodha whether the samanvaya is opposed or not, whether the samanvaya is opposed or not as to Brahma being Jagat Karana. What kind of Brahma? That Brahma who is Maya Shaktimat, one who is Sarva Shaktiman, Maya Shaktiman. Maya is his Shakti. Maya eva Shakti hi asya asti. Maya Shakti hi asya asti. Or Maya Rupa Shakti asya asti. Iti asya asmin vasti iti Maya Shakti mat Brahma. Tasya Maya Shakti matha Brahmana jagat sargam bruvan samanvayaha. So what is the asharirasya na maya iti nyayena? This maya is a shakti. It is like what? It is like antakkarana. Maya is also discussed as antakkarana, because it is the mind or intellect with which Brahma creates or blesses, or whatever is done, karma phala being given, all that is due to maya. So maya is like some kind of a karana. At least that much have to be accepted, that much has to be accepted. So if maya is karana, and since it is not visible, it is sukshma, and then you can say it is antakkarana. So that antakkarana samana maya, can it be in that which is ashariri, asharira, ashariram, brahma? Wherever you have seen indriyas which are sukshma being used by anyone, one who has indriyas, whether it is sukshma or antakkarana, the antakkarana and the indriyas need stula sharira to be there. Stula sharira becomes the adhikarana for indriyas and antakkarana to function. Therefore stula sharira should be there, some kind of a sharira should be accepted. Whereas Brahma is said to be having no sharira at all, stula or sukshma really. Therefore, Paramatma who is ashariri or ashariraha, Brahma which is ashariram, cannot have maya. So asharirasya namaya iti nyayena. Wherever we see any kind of, even the magician, you gave the example of magic, says the Purvapakshi to Siddhanti, the magician is showing this magic which is maya because he has a sharira. That mayavi is shariri. He is not ashariri. So asharirasya na maya iti nyayena maya shakti matha brahmana jagat sargam bruvan samanvaya virudyate nava iti sandhe. When such a doubt is prapta, is attained as to whether this, if you claim that Brahma is Maya Shakti Mat, then that Asharira Brahma cannot be Maya Shakti Mat. If he is, then there cannot be Ashariratum, there has to be Shariratum. So thereby Samanvaya Virodha is there. This Brahma who is said to have no Sharira by the Shruti cannot become Karana. Therefore this Samanvaya in Brahma being Karana is opposed. So when such a doubt comes up, virudhyate iti purva paksha, obviously there is a virodha, because Shruti says that Brahma is without any sharira. Siddhantastu sarvopeta sarvashakti yukta paradevata. This Paramatma is paradevata. Devata naam api devata is this paradevata, parabrahma, Paramatma, who is sarvopeta, sarvashakti upeta, sarva Shakti Yukta Ityartha. He is endowed with all sorts of Shaktis. Kutaha? Because not only does Shruti talk about Paramatma having no Sharira, but also talks about Paramatma having Sarva Shakti. Tad Darshanat. Tasya Sarva Shakti Yogasya Darshanat. Putra Sarva Karma Sarva Kamaha Ityadi Shrutau Darshanat Ityartha. Since there is a Shruti which says Brahma is परमात्मा सर्वकर्मा सर्वकाम. सो सर्वकर्मा मीन्स ऑल दैट कर्म विच टेक्स प्लेस इज ऑल ईश्वराज कर्म, परमात्माज कर्म. एंटायर सृष्टि इज परमात्माज कर्म. वॉट अबाउट स्थिति? स्थिति इज ऑल्सो परमात्माज कर्म. वॉट अबाउट लया? लया इज ऑल्सो परमात्माज कर्म. देन ईच एंड एवरी जीवाज कर्म इज हूज कर्म रियली? एक्चुअली इट इज इंटरेस्टिंग इफ यू थिंक अबाउट इट. सर्वकर्म यू कैनॉट हैव जीव कर्म विच इज आउटसाइड. ऑल्दो वी से दैट परमात्मा इज कर्म फल दाता, ही कीप्स गिविंग फला विच इज डिजर्व्ड बाय एंड क्लेम्ड बाय अर्न्ड बाय ईच एंड एवरी जीव विदाउट फेल. देर इज एब्सोल्यूटली no chance that somebody has done some karma and phala is not given. At an appropriate time, when the phala is ready to fructify, it will be given. As we saw that when you curdle the milk, there is no immediate curdling. Based on the weather condition, the temperature around, humidity, etc., there will be curdling in time. Similarly, as soon as a person has done karma, the phala is not given. If at all that were to be the case, then who would do swarga prapti karma? Karma for swarga prapti is done so that swarga is attained after the drop of this body. This person still has association with the family. He is not ready to go to the swarga. He is not ready to leave the body. It is only after the complete life is lived. Sharada Shatam. So when a person has lived close to 100 years, then alone he is ready to go. Generally, prayana. So one may want swarga, but after the drop of the body, let me live this life and then let me get swarga. Not immediately. One does not want to die immediately after the yajna, whereby swarga prapti is mentioned. Of course, those who have are so convinced that swarga sukha is there, that kind of a sukha I want, they may be ready. Therefore, prayana. But generally, a grahastha has to be doing this karma. So he is married, and one who has adhikara in karma should have a son also. Shruti says that. So he has Vishwasa not only one part in one part of the Shruti, but in the entire Shruti. Therefore, he knows that he has married as per the scriptures. He has begotten a son as per the scriptures. He has to do all the samskaras for the kid. So he has plan in place as to how should I, do samskaras and give Veda Pata Shiksha Ityadi to my putra who will be the karma adhikari after me. All this setup he has in his plan. As per the Shruti, of course. And thereby, when he is ready to go to Swarga, only then he'll be ready. Not ever ready. Therefore, Paramatma also, who is giving Swarga Phala, will be waiting for the karma to ripen to give result. Which is seen in the loka everywhere. You plant a seed, it takes a long time to become a sapling. Sometimes, even after a year, it does not grow enough. And after multiple years, there is Phala. Similarly, here there is a long drawn plan as to how this karma, set of karmas, will fructify into swarga phala or any other phala. And this kind of a phala is guaranteed to this jiva, therefore with shraddha he does it, the jiva does. By Ishvara it is given. Now that is sarva karma. Now jiva's karma also cannot be outside of this. Why so? I mean, this is an aside, okay? This is an aside for manana. Because all this is finally manana for us to aid in moksha. So when I am doing this karma, Shruti says that I am akarta. If I am not a karta, then who is doing this karma? If I finally say with jnana, I say no, I am parabrahma, nirguna brahma. I cannot have any sharira, let alone any karma, which is possible with the sharira. So I disconnect this tadatmya sambandha cognitively and I say it is not my karma, then the question would be, cognitively if I am dissociating, then I should also logically think as to whose karma is it, because karma is getting done. And Bhagavad Padacharya says in the shloka as to prarabdhaya samarpitam swapu. So you give your body up into prarabdha. You say that whatever is going to happen, it will happen. I will not claim ego, individuality and do karma. If it gets done, well and good, because something will get done. I will be faced with situation every moment. Shreyas, Prayas, I have to pick Shreyas as per Kathopanishad for my progress. Now if I have progressed enough in understanding that it is all Prayas and Shreyas are in the same category because they are both karma, cognitively I can dissociate and say that although I try to pick Shreyas, I am being pushed towards Prayas, there is a lot of Virodha. And this Virodha I have tried to counter again and again and again and again endlessly. But I know that I have no need for any further karma if I can dissociate. This is Jnana Avastha. So when I can disconnect and say that I don't care what this body does. As per dharma, it should do the right things, but I don't care anymore because I have completely disconnected. For such a jnani, whose karma is it then? Because karma is getting done. And you can say it is as per prarabdha also. Because the jnani has given up his sharira to prarabdha. Whatever it does, he has nothing to do with good or bad. There is no punya papa anymore. There is no agami karma. Sanchita is burnt. So prarabdha continues to tick like an arrow shot. This is what the granthas tell us, shastra tells us. Now whose karma is it? That karma is Ishwara's karma, sarva karma. So Ishwara will get the karma done. Not only punya papa phaladata as per shastra, but when the Shruti says sarva karma, karma is karman shabda napunsakalinga nakaranta napunsakalinga. How does it decline? Karma karmani. And here you have sarva karma pullinga. So it's bahuri. Sarvani karmani yasya paramatmanah saha paramatma sarva karma. So all karmas, you cannot put a qualification saying that only punya papa phala rupa karma, it is also kriya rupa karma. All those are paramatma's karma. As soon, in fact, for srishti and sthiti to continue till laya, paramatma has to get done karma from everyone. That is why not only the situation, conditions are created for the jiva to have is punya papa bhoga, sukha dukha bhoga, but also his antakkarana is tuned by samskaras which he has earned by earlier karma. And if he keeps on doing as per that, claiming that karma to be his own, then phala has to be given. When will the phala not be guaranteed to the jiva? Only when jiva says, I am no longer a jiva. Till then the jiva will remain a samsari. So by whatever reason the jiva is doing any karma, as long as he is doing karma, he is trapped. So when does it become karma yoga or karma bhasa? When he claims no responsibility for any karma. He says that I have nothing to do with any of these karma. Then his karma, even as a karma yogi, will become Ishwara's karma. Why? Because it is really Ishwara's karma. It is not jiva's karma at all. Jiva has neither created anything, nor does he have any material cause available other than what has been given by Paramatma. He does not have any buddhi or jnana of how to get a particular karya done except for what is given by Paramatma. The karya also comes about in time based on so many factors, including the prayers and karma of others. Therefore, the phala is also not under this fellow's control. It is also as given by Paramatma. So, what is really in the control of an individual? The buddhi that he does is given by Paramatma. The buddhi that he uses is given by Paramatma. The beauty of a person is given by Paramatma. So, there is no claim on beauty also. You say nothing, I just sit on in front of the mirror and I look at myself. I pose as whatever, you know, a selfies. That beauty is also given by Paramatma. So, buddhi, so whether it is beauty or brains, both are given by Paramatma. Everything is nothing but Paramatma really. Then, not only this prarabdha driven karma is Paramatma's karma, but Sanchita is also Paramatma's karma. Every karma, whether in Jnanavastha or Ajnanavastha, all are done by Parabrahma, achieved by Ishvara. Then what is it that this Jiva, what is the reason due to which this Jiva is an Ajnani and trapped? Because of this Avidya, he claims it to be his own. The Jiva claims it to be his own karma. As soon as he lets go that it is not my karma, and it is not by choice, okay? It is not by choice saying that, oh, I will pick which karma is mine, which is not mine. Meaning every dukkha or every papa karma is by Paramatma, and then, oh, every good karma is mine. Everything that brings a person fame is one's own karma, and whatever is bringing ill fame, defamation, is all Paramatma. That should not be the case, because this is a very tricky and shady area. It can get so, because people may get very choosy and say, okay, you know, whatever good is mine and whatever is bad is all Paramatma Kruta, and I have nothing to do with it. When one really gives up completely as to good or bad, I have nothing to do with it. Well, there are some who have another way claim also. One can say whatever good is Paramatma's. If a sadhu person, he'll say what? Oh, whatever good is happening in my life or whatever has been done, it is all Paramatma. Whatever bad is mine. It is okay to talk about in such a fashion to show humility, but that humility is ego again. Even if we say it, within we should know that all that is Paramatma. All that is Paramatma. You know, think about it. Somebody used to give an example. When Swami used to say, as to you are going on a road, on a highway, I mean, somebody is going on a road and meets up with an accident. Quite a serious accident, but is saved. So what does this person say? Oh, you know, Bhagavan ki krupa hai, you know, that I got saved. And not a scratch on me. The car is totaled, but not a scratch on me. Somehow I was saved by Paramatma. True. But then who caused this accident also? You cannot be choosy and say saving by Paramatma is Paramatma's karma, but the accident is caused by someone else. We don't have anything called as a devil, as other religions have. So that is also Paramatma. He is not only Sukhakarta, but also Dukhakarta. Because he has to give the Papa Karma Phala also. Thereby, the Sankata Nasha is also due to him, and Sankata Karta as well as Harta. So Sankata Harta only should not be accrued to Paramatma. As a Bhakta it is right, but then as a, in Jnana we should see that Sankata Karta is also Bhagavan, and really there is no Sankata Karana also and Harana also. Why? Because there is no Prapancha Srishti at all. That should be the final understanding. But here Sarva Karma, we can have Manana here on Sarva Karma, as to Sarva should mean Karsna Karma. It should not be Karsnena. It should not be by, you know, picking one over the other. So Sarva Karma and Sarva Kama, all his Sankalpas, he is a Satya Sankalpa. Whatever Sankalpa is done by Ishvara, that comes about. Ityadi Shrutau Darshanad Ityartha. So we see this in श्रुति इट्सेल्फ देयरफॉर सर्वोपेता च तद्दर्शनात् ब्रह्म एव परमात्मा एव पूर्वपक्षम अनुभाष्य दूषयति देन सिद्धांति टेक्स अनदर पूर्वपक्ष एंड हैविंग टेकन दैट पूर्वपक्ष ही शोज देयर इज नो सच दोषा दोषा विच हैज बीन मेड आक्षेप बाय पूर्वपक्षी दैट काइंड ऑफ अ दोषा डज नॉट एक्रूड द सिद्धांत व्हाट इज दैट विकर्णत्वात् नेति चेत् तदुक्तम् विकर्णत्वान् नेति चेत् तदुक्तम् सो विकर्णत्वात् न इति चेत् तद् उक्तम् नाउ द पूर्वपक्षी हैज सेड दैट देयर इज नो कर्णा ही हिंटेड दैट देयर इज नो कर्णा पॉसिबल अशरीरस्य न माया दिस वॉज नॉट देर इन द सूत्र बट द वृत्ति शोड दैट दिस इज द नाया बीइंग यूज बाय सिद्धांति बाय पूर्व पक्षी एंड दैट इज काउंटर्ड बाय सिद्धांति बाय सेइंग दैट सर्वशक्तिमत्वम इज देर इन परब्रह्म नाउ हाउ इज दिस सर्वशक्तिमत्वम पॉसिबल हाउ इज दिस कर्णरहित ब्रह्म हैव सर्वशक्ति So that is raised by the Purvapakshi in the Sutra form, taken up by the Siddhanti in the Sutra form. Vikarnatvat na. So Vikarnatvat na. Vikarnatvat means what? This Brahma is Vikarna. Meaning, he has no Karnas at all. Vigatani Karnani Yasmat. तद् ब्रह्म विकर्ण विकर्णम ब्रह्म तस्य भाव विकर्णत्वं तस्मात् विकर्णत्वात् सो दि ब्रह्म हु इज कर्णरहित हैज नो कर्ण अंतकर्ण नो ज्ञानेन्द्रियाज नो कर्मेन्द्रियाज सो हाउ कैन ही बी सर्वकर्म इत्यादि व्हाट आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ कैन परमात्मा परब्रह्म हु इज हैविंग नो कर्णज एट ऑल नो इंद्रियाज हाउ कैन He be Sarvopeta. So that kind of a question has been raised by Purvapakshi. So therefore, na Jagat Karana. This Brahma cannot be Jagat Karana because he has no Karanas. Therefore, Vikaranatvat Brahma Jagat Karanam na iti chet. तदुक्तम इट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन आंसर्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स इज द सूत्रकार तदुक्तम दैट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड एंड योर डाउट्स हैव बीन रिफ्यूटेड वृत्ति सर्वशक्तियुक्तानामपि देवादीनां चक्षुरादिकरण करणवतामेव विचित्र कार्यकर्तृत्वम् अवगम्यते पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट सर्वशक्तियुक्तानामपि देवादीनां दी देवास ऑल्सो हैव सर्वशक्ति need not be sarvakarma or sarvakamaha, but sarvashakti is there. Devatas, you pray to devatas to get some phala, they are capable to give that phala. And devadinam chakshuradi karanavatam eva vichitra karya kartruto avagamyate. They create vichitra karyas, devas, having what chakshuradi karana. You see, Indra is being described in a particular way. He has Sharira. You yourself established that earlier. In the earlier Adhyaya, you established that Indra can be available in multiple yajnas, just like with Sharira. Not just like with Sharira. Even with Sharira, the Purvapakshi had objected that there is no Sharira possible for Indra Ityadi. And then Siddhanti said there is possibility of being with Sharira because there is no pramana to say it is not there. The only pramana by which you know Indradi devatas is by Shruti pramana. Then what about their swarupa or their rupa, their vigraha? So they are having there is a description that he carries some kind of a weapon ityadi, all this. Discussion is also there in the Shruti, which is the only pramana for Indra. Therefore, Indra's rupa also is known only through Shruti. And you have, if it is Arthavada, of which Arthavada type we had seen this, and since you don't have any opposition to that statement, no Pramana is countering that, because no Pramana has accessibility to Indra or Indra's Rupa. Therefore, what if it is Arthavada? It is Bhutarthavada. It is as it is. There is some discussion in this Shruti, which is Arthavada, meaning it has nothing to do with the Karma Karma Phala, but it is still there. And then you said that even having Sharira, Karanas, Indra can be available in multiple Yajnas. And you discussed it in whichever way, like Namaskara by many, accepted by a single, or one single doing Namaskara to all of them. So we had seen that, and this was discussed. Therefore, Purvapakshi says that these Indradi Devatas who bless us, they have Chakshuradi Karana. So even if they are Sarvashakti Yukta, they are having Chakshuradi Karanas. Whereas your Parabrahma, who is being claimed as Sarvashakti Yukta, does not have Chakshuradi. Thereby, how can this Brahma be Jagat Karana of such a Vichitra Karya? So Vichitra Karya Kardutvam Avagamyate Kesham Chakshuradi Karanavatam Eva Devata, Devatadinam, Devadinam, who are Sarvashakti Yukta, all right, but they are also Chakshuradi Yukta, Karana Yukta. Brahmanastu. However, Brahma does not have Chakshuradi Karanas. How do you know? Brahmana Achakshushkam Ashrotram Ityadina Vikaranatva Avagamat Na Kartrutvam Iti Chet. However, this Brahma that you claim to be Sarvashakti Yukta, even if we accept that he is Sarvashakti Yukta, that Brahma is, it is Sarvashakti Yukta, still does not have Karanas. Chakshurindriya is not there, Shrotrendriya is not there, none of these are there, no Jnanendriyas, Karmendriyas are there, no Antakkarana is there, then how can this Brahma be Jagat Karana for this Vichitra Karya? Na kartrutvam iti chet, if that is raised, that kind of a doubt is there, atra yad uttaram vaktavyam tat purvam eva uktam, whatever has to be said as an answer to this has already been given as an answer in the sutra earlier, where na vilakshanatvat deva adivadapi loke ityadav uktam, it has already been said in these sutras. Siddhanti says that you go and look them up. Otherwise, if you want another answer, I'll give you Shruti Vakya, Athava Apanipado Javano Grahita Ityadi Shrutya Uttaram Uktam. So if you want an answer, I'll give you Shruti Vakya. If you want a discussion, you look up the sutras that we have already discussed, you recall them. Or Apanipadaha. Apanipada is what? Pani and Pada together will be Panipadam. Avidyamanam Panipadam Yasya Yasminva Paramatmani Sa Paramatma Apanipadaha. So Avidyamana Pani and Pada. Pani are hands and Pada are feet. So one who does not have hands or feet, who is Ashariri, does not have any Indriyas, Javano Grahita, but still he is very fast, he grasps as well, he runs very fast, or he goes very fast wherever Bhaktas call, Paramatma is available immediately, he's very fast, Grahita, and he grasps without hands. So basically what, he runs without feet and he grasps without hands, that kind of Paramatma is revealed by Shruti. Meaning what? He does not need hands and feet the way we need. Our pramanas are insufficient to understand how Paramatma works. Ityadi Shrutya Uttaram Uktam. Ataha. And why is this really possible? Because the Shruti is Kalpita and Panipada is not needed, just like in Swapna. In Swapna you don't have real hands and feet while you are grasping and running. You have imagined, kalpita only you have, because the kriya is kalpita, prapancha is kalpita, vishayas are kalpita, the grasping is kalpita, running is kalpita, the person who is doing is kalpita. So what is seen, what is held, what is run upon, all that is kalpita. So kalpita swapna srishti does not need akalpita satya panipada. That is the real answer. Similarly, Paramatma, who is imagining this prapancha, he does not need unimagined hands and feet, karanas. So for creation, kalpita srishti needs kalpana alone. Ataha srutyeka samadigamyatvat na tarkena virodha shanka avakasha iti. Therefore what? Srutyeka samadigamyatvat. Since all this can be understood only through shruti, Shruti is the ekameva advitya pramana. There is no other pramana. Everything related to Paramatma, Paramatma himself is what? Is Indriya Gochara. And for Indriya Gochara Vishaya, Shruti Veda Eka Pramana is only pramana, thereby Shrutyeka Samadigamyatva. If you have to understand, then you have to understand not only Achakshushkam Ashrotram, but you have to understand apanipadaha javanaha grihita also. Therefore, pratyaksha siddha what isn't, or whatever is pratyaksha agochara, their tarka anumana won't work. Na tarkena virodha shanka avakasha iti. So even if your tarka is opposing, that tarka has no play in shruti vishaya. Paramatma, parabrahma, shruti vishaya, whether he has karanas or not, is known through the Shruti, who he does not have. Then without the Karana, how does he work? Tarka won't work. You cannot raise that question. Why? Because Shruti says he works. He is in fact faster than whatever fastness you can imagine. He is faster than that. Therefore, what is available to be known, what is revealed only in the Shruti, can be understood only through the Shruti. How it is? If you want to use tarka, you have to use tarka in such a fashion that there is no contradiction. You cannot have ardhajarati and nyaya. You cannot pick one among the other, one among the multiple statements and say, I agree with achakshushkam ashrotram, but I don't know about apanipado javano grahita, how it will be. You can say, I do not know, then you ask Vedantins, we'll explain. But if you say that, you will point out this as a dosha in Vedanta, it is not. Because if you take achakshushkam ashrotram, then we'll show you apanipado javano grahita. So Shvetashvatara Upanishad talks about these. You take the Vedas in total and then you see how you can resolve contradiction, you will also land on the same conclusion that we have landed upon using the tarka, your own tarka, because we are also using the same tarka that you are using and trying to resolve apparent contradiction in the Shruti, and what we have landed on is perfect now. It is all Vivarta Kalpita Shrishti. This ends the 31st sutra and the Adhikarana also. We look at Prayojana Vattva Adhikaranam in the next part. संसिद्धमाध्यावर्जितम आनंदघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरूपास्मिः नमस्ते धन्यवादः
नमस्ते धन्यवादः
नमस्ते धन्यवादः